Hi everyone, it's been another minute. I've just taken a bit of time to get through my backlog of projects and I've also got a sweet new mic to boot. This video is kind of a continuation of the light up mask project I did a little while back. From the collection the mask was designed from, I also designed a light up jacket using the Lilypad Arduino as well. And more recently I had the opportunity to make one of those jackets for the comm, which is an online magazine showcasing Japanese street fashion and the online international community that surrounds it. So I thought I'd take this opportunity to film the process of making this replica jacket as a way to show you how it was done. So getting right into it with the materials. The main fabric is a cotton drill, which is lighter than denim but still has some structure to it. The lining is a black cotton fabric, which is both lightweight and more stable than using a satin or other fabric. The motherboard fabric was actually a very lucky find I got a few years back and have been holding on for a very special project like this one. Then for the trims, I have the metal jean buttons that you just hammer in, and orange thread for contrast, along with black and navy thread for the construction. I started by rolling out the main fabric, laying out the pattern pieces and cutting them out as usual. The pattern is similar to what you can see in a standard denim jacket, but with the pocket and collar specially designed to be more jagged, almost like it's pixelated. Now it is time to start cutting out the panels where the motherboard fabric will peek through. So time flies, and this project was actually made about a year ago, and a big part of this jacket was actually having the panels laser cut, but because we were coming out of lockdown at level 3, a lot of the public spaces that I would do this wasn't available. So alternatively to doing that, I ended up having to cut them all out by hand. So I was just chalking, marking out the lines from the pattern, and cutting them out as well as I could. And because the fabric edges weren't as clean as what it would be if it was laser cut, I put a little strip of glue along the edges to make sure that they remained clean and would not fray over time. Now it's time to attach the motherboard fabric to the outer main panels. By gluing it down first before sewing the edges, it really helps to make sure that all the pieces sit flat and won't move around. And edge stitching them down afterwards helps secure them to the garment and made sure that they stayed in place as the model wore them. So next is to construct the pockets. Because this pixelated shape that I'm trying to give across needs to be clean and pointy in order for it to look pixelated, I would bag out the flap and the pocket bag in two pieces, then clip the corners. Afterwards, I would turn it through and press it flat. Edge stitching the corners helps work as security for the sharp corners and to help emphasize the shape. Also gotta add the buttonhole before sewing it to the jacket to make things a little bit easier. Once the pixel pocket is sewn on, it's time to add the button. Now that the pieces are all prepped, I can now add the lily pads and conductive thread sewing to the front and back of the jacket. So here was my circuit plan for the front and back jacket pieces. The main differences are that the lily pad and LEDs are connected through 4 pins instead of 3, and the LEDs are just spaced further apart to be better distributed around the garment. And to program it, it was pretty much the same code as what I did for the mask. It was just renaming the pins and changing the sequence up to flash a little bit differently. If you would like more information about designing the circuit, as well as the way it was programmed, and just general tips and tricks, then please check out my previous Lilypad video or my blog in the description down below. Here are the components I used for the back in particular. It's pretty much the same as the mask project. We have the Lilypad, the battery holder for a AAA battery, LEDs, conductive thread, and standard sewing thread to secure the components down. The process of sewing the LEDs on is exactly the same as the mask project, it's just that the circuit has a couple more LEDs added to it. Before adding the LEDs, I also did a quick test to check that they worked, as that is kind of important. And then I started adding the components. First step is connecting the lily pad to the battery holder using the conductive thread and sewing it through the motherboard fabric. To sew it down, you can use a backstitch or any kind of thicker stitch that just helps strengthen the connection. And positive to positive, negative to negative. So once they are connected to each other, it is time to start laying out the LEDs. I tried to align them to the print to help it blend in, and once the placement was good, I sellotaped them down. Then it was just a process of going from each pin and connecting them to the LEDs on the positive end. And once that was done, it was just linking them all together on the negative end, and then after that, connecting it to the battery. When I flip the panel over, you can see the circuit a bit more clearly. Then you just switch it on and see those lights go. Now that the light's in and are working, it's time to put the jacket together, starting by attaching the front yoke to the front and the back panel to the side back panels. Now getting into the lining, I got the Brother Scan and Cut out again to make a custom label. It is always so satisfying to see it peel off so easily. When attaching the back yoke, the process is similar to the front pockets with a jagged pixel-like shape. The lining works well as a guide for where to attach it to, so the edges were clipped and pressed down to create some clean corners. After edge stitching the back yoke and front yoke with contrast thread, we can finally see the garment shape coming together when attaching the shoulder and side seams together. The front opening was pressed back and stitched down, then constructing the collar was next. Sewing the collar to the collar facing, edge stitching it down, then sewing the collar pieces together with the right sides together. Clip the corners, turning it through and then pressing it down to make sure everything is right. Then it's just attaching the collar to the neck opening of the jacket and sewing it down on the inside neck seam. Sewing it on the inside seam actually helps a lot because it makes a tidier finish when looking on the inside, as you're less likely to see the collar seam on the outside. The final step is just sewing the sleeves together with the cuffs and attaching that to the jacket armholes. Once again, it didn't record this, so I don't think it's particularly interesting. And finally, the jacket is done again. So what I'm wearing right now is the first iteration of the jacket. It's the same one that was worn on the runway. The second jacket is, of course, now in Tokyo. It has also been photographed, which is amazing. I programmed the second iteration of the jacket to blink a little bit differently to the first one, just to make it a bit more unique. But the beauty of the Lilypad, once again, is that it just can be programmed anytime, so you can always change it up if you want to. I don't know about you, but just staring at blinking LEDs is one of the most mesmerizing things to me. And here are some pictures of the jacket in action, courtesy of the Com. I would love to thank the Com team and Chum for helping arrange this. It has actually been an awesome experience, and the Com generally actually made a huge impact on the development of my original mini collection when it came to the research. To see the jacket in action being styled up by someone else is just one of the most exciting things to me as a designer. So I won't be making another one of these jackets anytime soon, but I do have various other LED light up fashion projects on the way. I am very excited to share them once they are finished, but until then, thank you all so much for watching. Hope you all have a wonderful day, and I will see you later. Bye.